lemon gelato.
Fresh from the freezer because it is stinking hot.
It is hot. So, well, lemon, I'm going to call it lemon gelato.
Relatively speaking, Canadian stinking hot.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure the people in Texas would have a spring jacket on.
Yeah, so lemon gelato.
Mm-hmm. Very refreshing.
Mm-hmm.
Very refreshing. So, this is a version of gelato.
Mm.
Gelato is one of those things that there are thousands of different versions and everybody's got a different idea of what makes a gelato. But generally speaking, gelato is more milk and less cream.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much it. Can have eggs, can't have
it's
eggs.
In theory, it's served at a slightly different temperature, too.
Served at a different temperature, and it has a different consistency.
So well, yeah, wait, because it's milk.
Because it's more cream. milk than cream. So, lemon gelato. Here's what I did. So the first thing you do is you heat up your milk in a pan and you zest in the lemons. Heat that to about 175 degrees Fahrenheit and that brings all of the oil out of the lemon and into the milk. In another bowl, I whipped up the egg yolks, the cream, the sugars, and the milk powder until that was pale, light, and fluffy. Then you whisk the hot milk into the egg mixture, whisking constantly so that you temper the eggs and you don't cook them. And then you pour it back into a pot and bring that up to about 170 degrees Fahrenheit. And at that temperature, you get a really nice thick custard. As well as cooking the eggs all the way through. Take it off the heat and you stir in the lemon juice. And then you put it in a container and you stick that in the fridge overnight. To make sure that it cools completely. The next day, when you take it out, give it a really good stir because you want to break up the custard. And then you put it into an ice cream maker. We've got 8 different ice cream makers in the basement, but it doesn't, they're all pretty much the same. You only get to, they only freeze it as far as sort of like a soft serve.
Yeah.
And then you need to put it in another container and stick it in the freezer to get it to firm up. I used milk powder, and the milk powder increases the amount of protein in the mixture, which slows down ice crystal formation.
Which keeps it creamy.
Which keeps it creamy. And I also used, part of the sugar I used was dextrose. And dextrose has the same effect. So it gives a really nice mouthfeel. Because one of the things with making ice cream at home is often you can get fairly big ice crystals because it doesn't freeze fast enough. And so those two things sort of slow down that process of crystal formation. Once again, I'm talking too much and Julie's ice cream is gone.
It's very lovely. Gelato, mm-hmm. Glen. Gelato.
Sorry. Gelato. Julie's gelato is gone.
I do like that lemon though. It's nice and tart.
Mm-hmm.
Very refreshing.
Cleans your palate right off. Excellent. Give this a try.